Assume this is between Thrill Seeker and Halo Forager. Halo Forager has slightly better stats due to color. Yeah, I like the Thrill Seeker here. I would like it if I could count on tabling the Rav, but I can't. I think I like Lutri over Preening Champion here. Given that I can be any red deck with Lutri. So, I mean, I think Furnace Rains is the right pick. It puts me down an awkward path somewhat because I think the like red-black sack deck wants multiple copies of cards, but if I have to abandon Lutri, that's fine. AJ Marowski, the 17 land stats don't tell you anything about how good the card is as a companion. They literally just don't interact with that concept in any way. Okay, I'm gonna take the second Thrill Seeker. Now what? Is Furnace Rains even good without a sack outlet? No. I have two Thrill Seekers already, though. Omnath has the highest upside. Counterpoint. Omnath's upside's not that high. Bond Warden's actually really good with Thrill Seeker. Come on, Rev. They can't let me have any fun. Okay. I'll bite on that. I guess I didn't think about exactly how good Jury with Thrill Seeker specifically is. I think it's just Rell's reinforcements. No, for Valduk. I'll table Valduk if I want it, I think. I guess maybe not because someone took the Rav. But I don't think Valduk's very good. I guess if you have a way to sack the three ones, it's something. Mad Moses, thanks for the raid. Welcome, Raiders. Third Thrill Seeker? Okay, this is getting weird. Take this one. Grab a few of the 4/3 defenders. You're saying you want me to play this thing? Unseal seems good with a bunch of thrill seekers. My playing loot tree. May or may not put it in my deck. It's not gonna be a companion. I don't think I want to prioritize multiple of these depth guards. I just don't think that they become anything that matters. Yeah, the preening champion here is pretty upsetting. I guess there's some weird situation where I get like multiple battles, and then I like Thrill Seeker on this, attack a battle, and then fling it at the opponent. Final Flourish, I guess. Better Moses? I mean, I guess it's just the etched. I don't even want to play this. Am I supposed to take Barrage? Different 40 gems? Obviously, I have to take this. I don't know that it's right over the spite, but with chat calling for it so much, and with three Thrill Seekers, I can't not take it. Grace, thanks for the follow. You can't count on tabling a rare. I'm just gonna do the thing. I'm not in any way arguing that it's right. I don't care. Beat stick to make the dream happen. Yargle seems very bad at 7 mana. I'm just throwing that out there. Obviously, there's nothing else to take in this pack. Denilius, thank you so much for the 8 months. Really appreciate it. Maybe I was supposed to take the 2-2 Trample there. I doubt it really matters. JB1, thanks for the follow-up. Burning Sun's Fury for Yargle. I will admit that's the best use I've ever heard of for Burning Sun's Fury. I don't know, Lala. It just happened. There's a Shatter the Source right here. And an invasion and another invasion. These can both kill things. I'm not looking at the lands yet. I'm obviously not playing two forests, but Thrill Seeker was listed. Invasion should be treated as a spell. Yeah, but it's a lot of work to do that. Opinion on the one drop Aki? It's not very good. That's my opinion on it. It is cute with a beat stick. I agree with that. All right. This deck seems very bad. You say zero forest. Zero forest is reasonable. The urn is good for splashing cheap green spells, but I really don't want to turn Yargle into a 7-mana card. You're saying my deck would be good if I put a kite sail on it? Because if you're trying to fix through Urn, you have to spend 7 mana. Because 2 equals 1. I don't think this is 5 instance. I'll double check, but I'm pretty sure it's not. Village Rights thing, Flourish, Deal 6. I don't think there are two others. Unseals one other, but that's it. All right, match predictions live. Forest, island, discard Warcrafting, play another forest. Love it. Dispersal this! is beam town, but doesn't really matter. We start the game in Yargle Fling with lethal range. Floating out. You don't think I needed all these lands? Oh. So the dream is to use Goreclaw to give Yargle Trample. Second Emoti. Why is this attacking? Oh no! Yargle, no! Well, I tried. Predictions live. Makes a 7-0 a bit more difficult. Yeah, it's hard to say for sure, but the odds have probably decreased. Well, the forest isn't optimal here, but it does cast the Yargle. Yeah, must keep, because this hand maximizes my chances of doing the thing, and we didn't really come here to try our hardest to win games. This hand lose? Well, I can think of one way. I pull off the combo. Can I please read Yargle and Multani's flavor text? I can do my best. I assume you're only really interested in one word of the flavor text. Man, if I had the mountain, my dreams could come true. Alright, maybe this forest is a scam. Aha! Hey, you don't know that the opponent's not also a Yargle player. If I had played Yargle last turn, it would have died to that. Not really. They still would have had all the other creatures, so yeah, really. All right. I've heard much about you from my daughter, Multani mumbled, rumbled. There was a time when I'd balk at your aid, Phantom, but she has shown me the merit in Urborg's strange ways. Pivot, replied Yargle. Long story, thank you so much for the two gifted subs. Congrats to Timber Okami and Mecha Doodles on your gifted subs. Diamond420, thank you so much for the gifted sub. Congrats to Ghost Code on your gifted sub. Skinny Villain, thank you so much for the subscription. Really appreciate it. Oh, and Sean's Johnson, thank you also for the 4 months. Ewig Kai TTT, thank you so much for the subscription. I appreciate it. Predictions Live. Extended, thank you so much for the 10 additional gifted subs. Congrats to Sarko ZQ1, Bimage Gaming, Rotate Translate, NOH Tharsonius, Diamond420, CMLRQN, Davidio, Scopix, Sewell, and Kilgore Trout on your gifted subs. And Jer, thank you so much for gifting a sub to So Bad. Really appreciate it. Very clever, Ranazura. Thanks to Reg Mizukin. Get him, Nizumi. Yeah. Mark P12, thank you so much for the 3 months. Really appreciate it. The perfect blocker. Alright. Oh, they got spicier than Omnath. Virus XT, thanks for the follow. Wait, I missed lethal there? If I take the... yes, whoops. Counters on the fox. Oh, just two counters on the fox. Fling it. And oh, I forgot that the Seeker can naturally sack itself also. Okay. So, if I, like, take the War Historian and attack with both, they have to take at least two. Then I counter on the War Historian and fling it, and they probably die. Steal the 4/4. Oh, just steal the 4/4, put counters on it, and fling it. And then also fling the Thrill Seeker. Campan, thanks for the follow. Yeah, a lot of different ways to win that one. Predictions live. Unusual amount of base burn in this deck. We do also have face burn battle, yes. Out of Multani range, not for long. Also, if you count the Thrill Seeker sacking itself, it's 21. Lurrus deck ended up an impressive 3-3. I think I like making a 4-4 trample. I don't love doing it into open mana, though. I think I just attack and reinforce. I mean, Thrill Seeker is a very strong card. I'm honestly happy they blocked the 2-2 and I just get to play the Slasher this turn. Just gonna attack. Do you have any this? It was in my hand. It was all scripted. I just kept having open mana and stuff. Zendikar getting invaded a lot this run. We have backed up a 1-1. Like, instead of playing this. There's another spot where I just didn't want to, like, do stuff into open mana. Unseal's not bad here, but kind of better after a Thrill Seeker. Oh, you're saying throw Thrill Seeker at the battle and then throw this at them for 5? That doesn't sound worth it. I can do that later. Like, this Thrill Seeker can let me do a bunch of throwing at +2 damage a pop. Non-creature source. Non-combat damage. Okay. They can Yarok Thrill Seeker, but they went for this thing. So I just flip this battle right now. Does that do anything? Only a 4-4 prowess. 4-4 prowess is pretty interesting. I'm looking for better than Force a Chump. I'm looking for kill them. Take that breach. Predictions live. This is certainly a thrilling deck. Life gain, disaster. Not enough of a disaster to flourish, but a disaster. Is the opponent playing 47 cards? 31? No, I don't think that, no. Think double Thrill Seeker is better than Thrill Seeker Familiar? Fair enough. So I guess I just do nothing, and then next turn, Thrill Seeker, attack, fling. I can't kill it if I back up. That's true, but... Yeah, maybe it was worth using a thrill seeker. I don't know. It's close. Too much open mana. Tom Richards, thanks for the follow-up. All right, one away from yargling my way to mythic. Predictions live. Explode, I have. It has the potential to be extremely fast and powerful, but it's really bad against removal. One thing that I didn't really mention that I really appreciated about that Yargle win that I got was the fact that, like, I actually needed it that game. Like, the opponent was doing things that were going to be stronger than most of what my deck does without the Yargle kill there. Moprix, thanks for the follow. That sounds true, Explode. Gregalus is a nice name for a Greg. Hey, a great invasion target. Get to do the 3-3 attack. So if I Furnace Rain's their thing, I can flip both battles. That's probably not good enough when they have tribute. Oh, flip this. Give me something good. That didn't kill them. Well, they don't have lethal on board. This is a big commie. Opponent has a lot of mana now. Ah, come on, Thrill Seeker! So if I attack with both of these, they have to block with all their things. To kill. So naturally, I'd want to kill this and this. So they put them on the same thing, and then I kill this. This. Have to chill. These both have menace. Oh, you're saying they could block just one of them? Oh no. Wait. I jump here. And I jump here. And they go to 7 and I... Oh, right, I can't jump this one. So I jump the 2 6s and I take 12 and then I kill them on the backswing if they don't have anything. Five and 8 is probably not 12. Yeah, that's true. That's bad. So in that case, I guess I have to just hope that I draw the dude. That's not the dude, but am I just actually gonna get 7 wins with this deck? Predictions live. Oh, that was a sweet game, one sure thing. GG. We are seeking some thrills. Oh man. So I guess I equip just one and then battle and kill their dude. So I think I hold this. I had lethal. It's so easy to have lethal with this deck. Alright, I'm sure I'll kill him next turn. All right, hear me out. What if we don't try to kill them? Oh. I made the mistake of thinking too hard. I really doubt that was a stream snipe. I think it was just they couldn't beat what was going on. That counts as a Yargle win. All right. Is this deck going to get a 7-1? Predictions live. My next attack step. There's no way my first attack step of a game is going to be lethal. That's a good hand. Look, no one said I was a combat expert. No one has ever accused me of that. Certainly not a find lethal expert. First time Scrap Chomper has shown up? I think so. We won the last game, of course. So I think I just make a 3-3 and jam. Interesting, Sarah. Trying to figure out if I could like Scrap Chomper and then like it probably goes reasonably, but I think it's better to just get this down and then attack next turn.
screwed.
Yep, Mythic Bargler. Invoke and then sack. What do you want me to sack this to do? Kill this thing now? Don't know that that gets anywhere in particular. Unseal it. Yeah. I suppose it does help set up unseal. Thing is, throwing this for 12 doesn't get me anywhere in itself. Milling Yargle also doesn't get me anywhere due to lack of green mana. I don't think it's useful to play the Thrill Seeker now. Might be time for this Scrap Chomper to start Scrap Chomping. They make a 5/5 scrap chomper. They just double block with these, and it's not that exciting. My concern here is I kind of want the Thrill Seeker to be able to kill the Aerialist. But, like, there's nothing particularly good to... I guess I can just put counters on one of these. So what if I attack with both of these? Okay, just kill this now. Flyers and just leave the scrap chomper back. But then they have these things that are kind of problematic. I guess I have the slasher coming down. I don't know that I care about the preening champion. I don't think I like my attacks. They just put this here and like these there and force me to kill the racer, which I could do anyway. I kind of think I want to just pass. Hate it. They can just flip Elish Norn here if they want, which they probably should. Google it. Oh, I'm very dead. See, the second chapter of this is win the game. lethal even if it block everything. Alright, so a deck check, and then we play for all of the marbles. Two? All of the marbles being, do we trophy with Yargle? That's the marble involved. Really just one significant marble. Ah, the old blue-black splash sunfall. All the Yarbles, you mean. Margle? I like Yarbles. I guess while in general I like Sunder the Gateway more than Oracle of the Mirror, I guess you really don't want to be splashing here. I mean, you don't want to be splashing a 2-drop. I guess you're already splashing a bunch of 2-drops, aren't you? Oh, but I guess these are knights for these things. Maybe it's your black that you're splashing. I didn't notice these twos. That's interesting. Oh, but we're over. So we could cut a lot of something. How important are these unseals? Like, my first thought is cut those and something. Oh, you do have a halo charged. Maybe one unseal. Cut all the white. I don't think I like that with Sunfall in the mix with 3 white dual lands and 2 earners available. Sounds bad to me. Cutting orders is just generally a good thing to do with a deck. This seems like it maximizes power level. Makes, like, Transcendent Message a little bit worse, but it's not like you're low on 1 and 2 drops. +866 +2 earns. Nice. Yeah, I like that distribution. Yeah, I think it's just cut those, run it. But also cut the Hawker. Absolutely not. With 2 earns and 2 weirds. And a Transcendent Message in a Meeting of the Minds? No, I like the second Cryptomancer. All right, prediction for the trophy. Get at it. Is Yargle the real deal? Have we come to Bargle? Have we ever? I did the real anime. Kind of want to just kill their thing. I don't really like opponents gaining life. I will definitely be at CubeCon. It's a local event that's very fun. That rude. Oh no. Well, if I draw a land, I guess I can Doomscar into a land. Wait, is that still a mana short? Do you need like infinite mana for this stupid thing? I need infinite mana. Yeah, I need six in play to do it. I kind of want to Furnace Rains this to dig for Yargle. Got a plan. They get to play this, and then I block. I mean, we're live. No, that kills me! Ah, I go to exactly zero! Doesn't stop the Yargle kill, but it puts me to exactly zero! Oh, I'm so disappointed! Ah. Yeah, with one more mana, I could block Fling and go to one. Oh, it also removes the ability. Yeah, well, wait. No. But it can't activate abilities, so it even if I give it the ability, I still can't fling it. Okay. Yeah. I was thinking it doesn't remove the power, but it, yeah. Okay. Well, we tried. The Yargle gave me outs, but opponent had the answers. So close. Mike, thank you so much for the cheer. Zero channel points, but it was worth it, I think. See, sleep on it and see how you feel about it in the morning. And the channel points don't matter. Bard Pit, thanks for the follow. Yargle didn't fail us, we failed Yargle. Well, now you're making me feel bad about it. Yargle giveth from the Yargle. Now that I agree with, Wunk. All right, that's going to be it for me. I have somewhere I need to get to tonight, but thanks for hanging out. There's an arena open this weekend, but I will not be streaming it because I am going to Minneapolis for the Energy. I'm going to hope to squeeze some attempts at the arena open in, like, between rounds there and stuff, but I certainly won't be streaming it. Good luck to everyone who's playing, and I'll be back next week. Have a good weekend, all that. Bye for now.